I'm Kate Krieger-Watkins here with another edition of The Scoop, and this is a special edition brought to you by Spectrum Health. And today I'm joined with Kaylee Peterson, Director of the Foundation and Community Relations?
Community Services.
Services. I never get them right.
That's all right. Throw it in there. Why not?
So, how are you, first of all?
Yeah, we're good. We're good, right? I mean, just being flexible and nimble and adjusting as things evolve.
You have to do that.
That's right.
Even without coronavirus.
That's right.
Yes.
That's
so.
Right. Mama three, that's just the way that life is.
Yes, I understand. So why don't you tell everybody a little bit about why we look so fabulous?
I mean, I'd like to say it's from coronavirus, right?
Yes.
Yes. No. No, we're here today to talk about a new challenge that we're doing through the foundation at the hospital called the TOAST Challenge.
The TOAST Challenge.
Yes. And TOAST is an acronym, which stands for Together Overcoming Adverse Stressful Times.
Okay.
All right, and clearly you do that by wearing a clown wig.
Yeah, and there have been some stressful times in the last 6 months.
Yes, there have, yes. But what this challenge is so nonprofits really across our community have been challenged on how do we fundraise and how do we engage safely kind of in light of all of this.
Right.
So our board came up with this challenge, the TOAST Challenge, as a way to have some solidarity in the community and give a toast to our healthcare workers, our patients, and our community. But we're asking people to do it in the most creative way possible and have some fun, right? Which is, I mean, what's more fun than this, Kate?
Right, I know.
You know?
I'm brewing my tea.
So we're really challenging businesses, patients, staff, our board members, our community at large to kind of get involved in this, have fun, post it online throughout the month of August. And funds raised through the effort are going to go towards our community benefit programs. So I think many are familiar with Win with Wellness.
Mm-hmm.
All of our community benefit programs really kind of fall under that umbrella, under that hub. And, you know, we've had some health disparities within our community that have been here for a long time. But when the pandemic hit, it just really shined a light on a lot of what exists in our community.
Sure.
And so there's a lot of concentrated effort right now to figure out how do we best address that. So funds raised through this effort are really going to go to that program.
Why don't you talk a little bit about what you guys have seen more shine a light kind of on themselves during the COVID-19?
Yeah, so, you know, I think one of the things that we saw right away is in an era where we asked everybody to go virtual, we struggle with connectivity in this county and in the surrounding counties. And so how do we properly provide people healthcare access if they can't physically get to us,
mm-hmm.
if they can't connect to us? And then if they're missing that care and care becomes more episodic, chronic disease manifests and we see unhealthy choices. And so as we really look at how do we partner with our schools, how do we partner with other area nonprofits, how do we collectively address these issues and really try to make a dent in what we see within our community?
Sure. So this is taking place instead of your annual huge masquerade ball fundraiser.
Yes, our benefit ball.
So can you give kind of a background on just that and how it's looked over the years and how you want this to look to replace that? Because, I mean, you guys make a really nice amount of money at those every year.
We do, yeah. And I would say that although this event is happening during the same time period, it's nothing like the benefit ball. I mean, I might wear this.
I was going to say,
I might wear it to the ball if the theme were appropriate.
Circus.
Yeah, but this is really, you know, like I said, really we looked at, we also understand that the economic impact this time has had, right? So we really are looking at this as an opportunity to engage with the community, to celebrate a lot of the hard work that's taken place, not only within our healthcare system and at the hospital here, but really throughout the community to kind of hold each other together, lift each other up, celebrate each other, and hopefully raise some money for a really great cause while doing that.
Yeah, well, awesome.
Yeah.
Well, can I make a cheers, a toast?
Please, let's have a toast. We've been saying a toast to health and hope.
A toast to health and hope.
Yes.
Well, here's a toast to health and hope. And to all the healthcare workers and anybody who's been affected and helped out during COVID, this goes to you. And make sure you check out where can they find the information to donate, to nominate, to submit photos,
yes.
videos, yep. all that kind of thing.
Yep, we will have an event on Facebook with all of the details.
Okay.
And you'll be seeing some promotional videos coming out very soon from our board chairs. That help tell you exactly what to do, how to give, where it goes, and some ideas on how you nominate. So
awesome.
Tag your friends, your family, please be involved, get engaged, support our community, support our local hospital.
Well, great. Well, cheers again.
Cheers.
Toast.
Cheers.
To our healthcare.
Cheers.
Hi, I'm Scott Smith.
I'm Bob Budrow.
I'm Brandy Miller, here with my friend, Mr. Mooney.
These are stressful times we're in.
And I'm taking the opportunity
to celebrate the positive.
And partake in the Toast Challenge.
What is Toast, you ask?
Toast is a virtual toast.
To our healthcare teams,
our patients, and our community.
Have someone you want to give a cheers to?
This is your chance to do so and benefit a good cause.
Throughout the month of August, I'm encouraging you
to raise your glass,
ice cream cone,
coffee cup,
or water bottle,
and celebrate our hospital,
patients, and community.
But listen, get creative, have fun.
We can't wait to see what you come up with.
And yes, there is a prize for the most creative.
Make a donation. Check out the link in this post.
And challenge your family, friends, and colleagues to join in.
So hey, let's toast to health and hope.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Cheers.